So today is Tuesday, and we arrived yesterday with Jose from the tour of the smaller island we did. And now it's the start time for preparing the transatlantic. So I was supposed to cross the Atlantic with a friend and my father, so three people on the boat. So that's why I was supposed to cross from Cape Verde. But since my friend who was supposed to come changed his plans, since we're only two people, I decided to take more time exploring the Canary Islands and cross from here. So the distance to cross is longer. There's about like 600, 700 miles more. But since we are only two people on the boat, it's fine for what I have to carry of water and food for the passage. Now my father is arriving on Thursday, so in 2 days. After there is this weekend the Carnival here in Canary Islands, so we're gonna stay for this. And as soon as the weather forecast is good after the weekend, we go. This week is all about preparing the boat, getting things ready, provisioning. So I have a list of things to do. I'm going to try to go through it. A bit of party this weekend and go. So yeah, looking forward for this. Not to forget anything because there is no shopping in between. So yeah. Okay, here we are at the airport in Gran Canaria, Las Palmas, with Jose. We're going to pick up my father, who's arriving from France, and the weather is terrible, so I don't know how we're going to do to prepare the boat with this weather, but let's see.
Our fans, come to Carnival in Gran Canaria. It's the time to party, not for sailing, just partying. But we are going to costume like sailors man. Yeah. No, yeah. Sailors girls, I think. Sexy sailor girls.
He likes to fancy dress as a girl. Don't ask me why.
Fancy dress.
With my dad on board, we could start the preparation course, starting with the provisioning. To start with the provisioning, Jose was again an amazing help and took us to his family company where we could buy in large quantities products such as rice, pasta, canned food and other non-perishable supplies.
La pasta finalmente.
Ah, sí, spaghetti.
Una caja de
spaghetti.
Queso.
Cada caja trae 5 kilos. Okay.
This is humanitarian aid coming from France. We have lots of dried tomatoes from the neighbor, chocolate and more chocolate and also homemade marmalade, and this, I don't know what it is.
Almendras pasta.
Yeah, whatever. Lots of food.
Yeah.
Ok, alors je veux bien que tu me passes les tomates en premier.
Thank you.
José is taking us for a tour of the island. It was his first studies.
Turismo, guía de turismo.
Yeah, I think we can look for a waterfall now because it was raining a lot, so it's possible we can see a waterfall here.
Yeah, normally the island is really dry, but now it's pouring rain, so it's really annoying to prepare the boat, but at least for seeing the island, it's nice. And maybe we find a waterfall.
Buena.
Okay, so we have to cross this river, trying not to get too wet.
She'll be the one that moves you.
Et après là c'est bon, c'est plus très profond. Il y a un peu d'eau au milieu. Ouais, je vois ça. Change. She'll be the one that shapes you. So you better end. The wind is so strong up there that the water is not even touching the floor. Look.
On your tongue should always be the saddest song you've ever sung. On your tongue should always be the saddest song you've ever sung. Love will be the only thing you need. Don't let it fail you. Don't ever let her go.
Alright, so we're here at the marina having a quick lunch, and now we're going to go to the second round of provisioning. Yesterday we went to Jose's company to buy all the large quantities, and we're now finishing the list to go to the supermarket and finish to buy all the smaller products, and the last round will be on Monday or Tuesday, right before we leave, to buy the vegetables and the fresh products that we're taking, even if they're not that many because I don't have a fridge, so that's a lot easier. This is the list. nothing, and this only tells how difficult it's going to be to feed all this food in the boat, considering that we already loaded some stuff yesterday. So yeah, let's see. Right, so before getting the stuff in the boat, what we do with the cans is that we put the name on the can, on the top of the can. So this one is maize. And after we remove the label, so this after we can store it in the bilge, and the humidity inside the boat and the water won't like remove the label that is after getting stuck somewhere everywhere and it's dirty. So yeah, that's how we do it. So we have lots of them to do. Ok, maintenant les boîtes. Ouais. So it looks like that almost all the non-perishable stuff made it to some locker. Only this that I have still to fit somewhere, and then the vegetables, but probably I'm going to put a net somewhere around the boat to also put vegetables, because otherwise it's never going to fit. Right, so yesterday was Carnival night. I went with Jose and some friends out, so this morning was a bit hard, but yet we completed all the to-do list on the boat that I have on this. So we took down the mainsail and the Genoa to do some minor fix on them and check them properly. I went up the mast, this was yesterday, to check that everything was going good up there, so everything is good. Some minor projects on the boat were still to be done. Some small stuff like checking all the manila, check that they were closed properly, put back the gas bottle in its spot. And yeah, now we're almost all good. Few things to do tomorrow, like mount back the winches with some grease, and that's it. And now I have to work on the pharmacy because it's a mess.
So this is one of the things that I've been postponing for a while. It's organizing the pharmacy of the boat. Look at all this. There is approximately 350 euros worth of all kind of drugs and medicaments. So what I'm doing now, instead of having lots of boxes like this, I just put them in small bags like this. I just took the pills out, and I keep the manual and the front part of the box, and I put them in the sealed bags, so I can discard all the rest of the boxes. It won't get wet if anything happens. It's also easier to organize and to store this way. So yeah, that's one of the few things that I wanted to do before the crossing. And actually I take the advantage of being here in the flat that Jose is letting us in for a few days, so I can like have everything around and organize all this.
Hey, so we're Jose here in the elevator. So yesterday was like kind of a big party, and today we're getting his car, getting on the ferry, going to Tenerife.
We come back to Tenerife, but not in an 8 meters boat, but more like in a, I don't know, 100 meters boat.
Yep, fast. So 1 hour to go there. We spend the night there, and tomorrow morning, first time at 8 o'clock in the morning, we take the ferry.
That's
back
the idea. Here. Let's see what happens.
That's a 12-hour party in Tenerife. Carnival. Yeah. We need to get fancy dress now. Okay, so we found so many fancy dress at Jose's place that we can have Carnival like for an entire week with different...
Yes, it's the market of the Castiles.
Okay, so we made it to Tenerife. I did not have the camera inside, but basically it was like this inside the ferry. So yeah.
Okay, so it's Tuesday 14th of February, and it's a bit hangover day from Carnival. It's actually good that we're leaving for the transat because I cannot take much more Carnival anymore. So yeah, just one stop by the petrol station, refill a bit of gas, of diesel, and that's it, we're off. Last we fill the water, we have vegetables, we have everything, so yeah, just go.
Bueno, ya está, eh?
La gorra esta?
Es de aquí.
Ah, esto es de aquí?
De bon.
Mira, que se van. Vas a decirle adiós.
Vamos, que nos vamos.
Bueno, chicos.
Chao la familia, chao José. Gracias.
Lo haremos.
¿Cómo? ¿De verdad?
Sí.
Adelante, mamá.
Chao.
Pues la pena, mamá.
Right, so we're off. This is Las Palmas behind me. Jose and Marcos and his family came to say bye, and that's it. We're off for months. No going back. So yeah, exiting the harbor at the moment. And 1 month sailing downwind, more or less, even if right now we're going to do a bit of upwind ridge. Part of the game.
Okay, so far we're not moving much, there is not much wind, but we're right there, next to Gran Canaria. We left a few hours ago, and we're going to go all the way to Martinique. So yeah, that's about 3 weeks, something like this, a month, we'll see. We should get some wind later tonight, and get the trade winds that are like pushing in this direction.
Annabelle is a firecracker falling down.
Stay tuned for the next episode to see more about this Atlantic crossing. I'm sure you don't want to miss nice sunsets, contrary winds, Cairo psychology, and became sailors. And of course, more sunsets.